They also got distinguished ratings at our spring concert assessment. And so that's really exciting because all three groups were distinguished. That's the first time we've taken three groups, and for them to all three be distinguished, we were really, really proud of them. So we're going to start off with celebration and song.
Thank you.
championship softball game got rained out last night. So the starting catcher also plays trombone, so she kind of had to go catch two points. But we're missing Addison and Emily. All right, our next piece is a traditional English Morris dance tune. So I told the kids kind of imagine, I don't know, little shepherds scraping some in a field. But you'll kind of get that feel for it. This is Shepherd's Hay.
Thank you.
first time we played at Mr. Bell might have been a senior. But going back pretty far, we played it about three different times. We've used it twice in a marching band show because we had so much fun with it. But I told the kids, I said, I'm going to tell you guys to picture you're part of a caravan riding across the desert, and you stop for the night, and you have your caravan, your wagon circled, your camels are resting, and then it gets a little wild, and everybody's showing off for each other, and it's a kind of a party and a feast and a festival around the campfire. So we're going to take you on this little trip, this little caravan trip with the Arabian dances.
Thank you.
middle schoolers come very quietly, because while they're coming down, I want to take a minute and recognize our Harlan student. Harlan. Okay. Now, while Harlan's making her way out here, I'm going to tell a quick story. So Harlan started a band, and she was a baritone player. And she was a really good baritone player. And then her freshman year, I think we're in her freshman year, our tuba player started flaking out on us at band camp. And if you know anything about band, especially marching band, if you don't have a sousaphone out there on that field, the judges are kind of like, eh. And I was like, we gotta have somebody. And my band camp staff was like, Harley can do it. She's smart, she has an ear, she's strong, she can do it. And so we started trying to like plant the seed, but Harley wasn't really having it. And so finally we get, the kid leaves, he ditches us, leaves, I think he went to the county. And I'm like, well, we've gotta have a tuba. And we were desperate. It's like 3 weeks before the first contest. And I was like, Harley? It was after school, and it was me and our percussion instructor and the former band director from Cumberland was helping us. I said, Harley, if you just play tuba for marching season, I will pay you $100 out of my pocket. I will give you 50 right now, and I will give you 50 at the end of the season. And she's drawing on the board, and she's like, And Mr. Mick, in his frustration, he's like, Harley, what's it going to take to get you to play this tuba? And I thought he was going to plot a snowball. And Harley looks at me and she said, I don't want your money, but if I can be drum major when I'm a senior, I'll play tuba as long as you need it. I was like, dumb. As you can see, she's our only senior, so she said, Shaden Crow and Camille No and Jordan Rodriguez were selected to the SKMA Middle School Honor Band. And when we did the concert there, they played this piece called Metalheads. And they had so much fun with that, I was thinking, I'm going to order that for our kids. And so we're going to play it all together. The composer wrote it based off 80s rock music, so it's got kind of rock vibe. There's a lot of metallic instruments going on in the back. And so you'll hear a lot. And this is going to be loud. Just like forewarning. Mr. Bell likes to be on, he's right, we are very different. And he's been like, shh, not too much children. I'm like, come on, play out. So we're gonna play out. This is Metalheads.
Thank you.
super crazy, super busy time of year. We so appreciate you all being here. I think Mr. Morton had something he wanted to say before we run away.
I want to take just a couple moments to, one, say how much I appreciate these families. I was a band dad for a short time, and but it did something to my kid when he was in the band. When I think of the band, I think of two things. I think of the heart and I think of the head. And to get out here and do what these kids do, the cognitive impact that it has in the classroom cannot be measured. And then when you really get there, it's when it starts touching your heart. And so for my kid who was in band, who now plays the guitar and the piano, and that's what he does with his spare time, it brings me nothing but joy. Or when I find myself running on Ivy Hill and Peyton Huff is playing this trumpet, I just want to start crying, and because it really touches you in a way that nothing else can. And we've had a long history of unbelievable talented people who devoted themselves to the music. I think of Miss Pope and Miss Schrader. We've got Mr. Bell, and we've got Mrs. Burkhart. It's difficult to quantify what they mean to so many people, and it's hard to express just what an impact they have on the community and your school, the culture. And it's not by accident. We have a lot of people that work in our school system. Some are great, some are good, and some are phenomenal. And Ms. Burkhart is phenomenal at what she does. I just want to say how much I appreciate her. She's made my job as a superintendent really easy because I get the unbelievable joy of getting to celebrate so many successes that happen because of her dedication, her commitment, her professionalism. And it's going to be missed, but I know Mr. Bell's going to do a wonderful job. Big shoes to fill, like you said. Normally, we would recognize Mrs. Burkhart and the band. We had some things planned and schedules got mixed up, but I do have a gift on behalf of the Board of Education that cannot be here tonight. And nice award presented in appreciation for the many, many lives that you touched. And so again, I can't say, can't adequately put into words what you meant to the band program, what you mean to Harlan High School and Harlan and the school district, but we want you to know that you're loved and appreciated very much.
Ms. Burkhart off with one more song.
How much joy this job has given me, and how much I love these kids. I'm gonna miss them, but I told him I'm not moving, I'm not dying, even though all the nice things people have said. What is going on? So, thank you guys for giving me the privilege of being in front of these guys for all these years. All right, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to give Ms. Burkhart a one last Harlan band.